Hello, everybody. This is Nia Pierce, editor-in-chief at SheaTech.com, and I am here with my team leads, Erica, who is my right-hand woman here at SheaTech, and Jaleesa, who is my left-hand woman here at SheaTech. I'm going to go ahead and let these ladies introduce themselves. Erica, you go ahead and take it away. Please tell the people what your position is at SheaTech.
What's going on, everyone? Yes, I am Erica. I am basically the second in command. Right? I'm pretty much
You're pretty much me when I'm not me.
I'm the backup. Yeah, my official title is I'm the manager of operations, and I'm also a team lead. I also write and edit if necessary. So yeah, that's pretty much it.
Sweet. Jaleesa, why don't you go ahead and tell the people what it is that you do here at the website?
What's going on, everybody? This is your girl, Jaleesa. Basically, I'm a field manager, team lead, and writer. Basically, when we're out on the field, I'm dealing with telling everybody what to do when it comes to interviewing, doing camera work. I write a little bit as well, and I do a couple of interviews every now and again.
Jaleesa is definitely the one that we depend on when we're out in the field. She's the woman with all of the equipment. And not only is she the woman with all of the equipment, but she's the one who has like the vision. She's kind of like the visionary of the site. Like, I know I'm kind of fluffing you up, but I have to give you your credit. Like, when me and Jaleesa went to PAX 2014, like, that's the only event that we've had an opportunity to really work together. Like, she's very professional. She knows exactly where you should stand. She knows exactly where the interviewee should stand, and everything just looks so good. And then, you know, the added qualities of her knowing how to work the equipment, like, she's just really great. And then, you know, Erica, she's just everything. Like, sometimes, like, I come like to Erica and I'm just like, oh my god, I don't know what to do. And she's kind of like the mellow out person. I mean, Jaleesa has her place as well as a person who kind of helps me mellow out, but like, you know, Erica, you know, she's always got her Twitter on. So like, whenever I have a problem and I shoot the Twitter out to Erica, and she's all like, it's okay, you know, we can do this.
I got you. That was crazy. You was going haywire, and I'm like, Nia, we'll figure it out.
We got it though. Me and Jaleesa went in and we did that thing. Like, that's what it's all about. So these ladies here, when I say that they are my right hand and my left hand, like, I don't mean that just to be cute. These ladies get me through, you hear me? So I'm very, very grateful for them. And so, introductions aside, I don't want to go on too much about that, but I want to let you guys know that we've got this new show, and this is essentially like our pilot episode, if you will, called Boss Lair. You know, we just kind of came up with the name. It was something cute, and we were like, well, since we're all team leads, why can't we name it something that's kind of related to what we do at the site? So Boss Lair was a really good name that we came up with, and it stuck, and we love it. And we also have a really awesome logo that you guys will see on this video, made by a fellow SheaTech member, one of our writers, Char, and hopefully our future podcast manager when she's not so busy.
Shout out to Char.
Shout out to Charnell. Homegirl comes through with the pixel art. And if you guys are familiar with what we do on the website and familiar with what we do on this channel, she is the one who also made the pixel art for the loading screen. So shout out to Char. She's a very valuable asset to the team. And if you ever need any pixel art done, be sure to let her know. I will put her DeviantArt information in the description so that you guys can hit her up. She's really, really good at what she's doing. Let's try to make her be this pixel art beast that I know she can be. And so basically, that the way that the show is going to run is that this show is going to be specifically about video games and what's going on in the video game industry. We're planning on doing this show to start once a month, and then whenever we get a hang of the way that the show is being run and when we find a day that works for everybody to come and do the recording, we want to maybe start getting the episodes out sooner than a month, maybe like every other week or something like that. And maybe even sooner than that if time allows or if the demand is there. So if you want to see more from us, make sure you support us and let us know that you want to see more from us, because I mean, we can do it, but y'all got to show us that that's what y'all want. And the way that we're going to set it up is we're going to have at least 3 topics or less. We want to try to keep these short, kind of more like a mini cast setting, so 30 minutes or less. And we also plan to have a portion at the end of the show where we answer maybe one or two questions from you guys. So whenever you guys are watching and you're engaging with us, make sure you also ask us questions, because your questions could also be on the next episode of Boss Lair. Another couple of good things coming to Boss Lair, as well as the website as a whole, is that we're going to be creating a store. So you guys can buy She Attack related merchandise soon. And there's also going to be some new incentives on our Patreon. You know, we're trying to get a little bit more serious about bringing our web shows to the forefront. And we also wanted to kind of be more of a collaborative effort. We want it to be, you know, we make the content and we want you guys to give us feedback and tell us how we can be better. And, you know, we just kind of ping off of each other. So that's kind of what we want for the show. But I feel like I'm talking too much, so I'm going to hand it off to my team lead. So, you know, why don't you guys tell me, what is it that you want to see from Boss Lair? What do you think that we can bring to Boss Lair?
Oh, man, that's a good question. I guess just the dynamic between us, I think, is really, you know, it's going to be strong. We mesh well together.
Yeah.
So I think if we could just show our personalities to people watching, you know, and then like you said, they can give us questions. They could be gaming related, maybe even off topic.
Maybe,
you know,
yeah.
Random questions or something. And, you know, we could really make this fun and entertaining.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like all of us have so many different interests, but we all get along and stuff like that. So I think it's going to always be, well, we like this or we don't like that. And it'll be great discussions.
Right.
Because all of us like different things. So. Right. I think that's a good thing.
Yeah, we would have some good discussions. Every one of us has our own mind, you know. Even though we all mesh well, we are very different fundamentally in what types of games that we like and, you know, things like that. So, you know, we can come together and have some interesting discussions, but at the same time, respecting each other, because we all respect each other. We're all colleagues. And another thing that Jaleesa talked about before we started this show is she wanted to talk about United Front Games, right?
Yes, ma'am.
You guys gotta fill me in on this. I'm a little behind on this one, so you guys take this one.
Well, they did closing their doors, ma'am.
And it's so sad. Like, it makes me so sad. Like, I'll be honest, I didn't really play a lot of the stuff that they made. I knew that they made Sleeping Dogs. Of course, that was like one of their more popular games. But I also did not know that they were the ones who made Mod Racing Nation or something like that. And they also made the Little Big Planet carding game. They're the ones who are behind the ports for, I think it was the original Tomb Raider. And was it Master Chief Collection that they ported as well?
Yeah, they helped with that.
And then they also were making a new game that was actually on my personal channel that was on Steam called Smash and Grab. And it was a really good early access game. That game literally just came out at the end of September, and they had to take it off the Steam store because they were closing their doors. So I just think it's really sad that we're losing another video game company with as much potential as them. Because Sleeping Dogs, I have Sleeping Dogs, but I haven't had a chance to really just play it like that. So it makes me want to actually go back and play it some more, because I mean, to lose a company with so much potential, man, like, that's always a very sad situation. And then another thing happened where Red Dead Redemption 2 was officially announced, and there's gonna be a trailer for Red Dead Redemption 2 tomorrow, right? The 20th?
7 a.m. I think.
Yeah,
I'm getting up early.
That's pretty exciting.
Oh, yeah. That's I'm planning to write about it and everything, so.
That's so I have to be early with that then. Yeah,
So what Red do you guys, Dead? Yeah, what do you expect from Red Dead, Jaleesa? Go ahead, tell us how you feel.
And all I can say is the first Red Dead is, like, in my top 10 games of last generation.
Oh, nice.
So that, Red Dead just is that good, so, when I saw Rockstar do what Rockstar does, which was Sunday, This is how everybody knows Rockstar is nothing but they just petty. They put their logo in a red background, and that was all they put, and people went crazy, including me, because we already know what that means.
But tell us your theory. What'd you talk about?
I mean, I'm just saying, like, this just the thought of just me being a gamer and just seeing that lets you know how good Rockstar is as a developer.
Yeah.
But I got a feeling that we may get a prequel. just by what they showed on the actual logo thing they put up yesterday, letting everybody know that it was Red Dead 2. It's got like a clan of, it's like 7 people. So I'm thinking that we may play a prequel, but I don't know. I'm not sure. And we may get the Sun story, or we may get another story in general. It just be in the same type of area. Mm-hmm. Or it may be in the same world as the first one, but a whole different, just a whole nother set of characters. Right. So who knows with Rockstar?
I was just saying, it was also, they also said it's supposed to be coming out in the fall of next year, yeah?
Yes, ma'am. They say that, but I
don't think that.
I'm just being real. Rockstar, as good as they are, 2018. So that means PC won't get it till like 2019.
Probably not.
Still before God of War, though.
Oh,
I'm just saying.
It may be. I don't know, but you know what though? As much time as they want with God of War, they can have it. I'm just being real. Rockstar can take as long as they want. I don't care how long it takes.
I feel like I'm one of the only gamers who don't really care about delays anymore, because I would rather a company like take their time and try to make the game the best that they could possibly make it than bring it out too soon and it has like problems. Because there's so many games that have like good intentions and good foundations but are like ruined from like bugs and other little like...
Like Mafia 3, right?
Yeah, like Mafia 3.
Elisa knows.
Yes, I do know, and I'm kind of mad that I know.
Yikes. Yeah, I would rather them just take the time, man. You don't need it anymore.
Riddled with glitches.
Yeah.
They needed, like, at least maybe a couple more months to knock out the rest of the glitches. But, I'd rather that, like, dealing with somebody of Rockstar's caliber, I don't care how long they take.
Like, take just your time. Real.
Yeah, like that is just being real.
Regardless of when it comes out, it's going to be a good game. Like, they have that track record where regardless, you know it's going to be good. So take your time, because we know that regardless, it's going to be fire. It don't matter when it comes. Like, people are still going to want this game. So just do what you got to do, you know, and it's all good. So
what about you, Erica?
I'm hyped, man. I loved the first one, Red Dead Redemption. That was one of my favorite games last generation. So I'm really hyped for this. And once I saw the picture, you know, and it had the red background, I just knew already. I'm like, this is coming. And like you were saying, them as a developer, like they have that reputation where they can just put up a picture and everybody just goes wild.
Everybody did. It was just so crazy. Like, they just put their logo with the R on it in a red background, and that was it.
That was it.
That color alone just, you know, made everybody go crazy.
Yeah.
And you also have the other people, you know, the other side of things, they're complaining about stuff. Oh, we can get into that too, right?
Over these people. It's crazy. So
it's like
them.
It's like they're never happy. They're never,
never happy. Like, that's just, geez. I think that's just being fake mad. Like, you're just mad. You're just, like, fake rage. Mad. Fake you want people rage. To retweet what you say.
Exactly. They're mad about the title. They're mad it could be a prequel. They're mad about anything.
I don't understand what they want.
Like, gamers don't know what they want. They don't know what they want, man. That comes with everything coming with the... Just everything, period, with the gaming industry. People don't know what they want.
You know what I think? I think generally people know what they want. But I think that gaming is one of those kind of, like, mediums where people invest so much of their time and their money into this hobby that they want to feel things, whether it's extreme hype, whether it's rage, whether it's sadness. People want to feel things because they feel entitled to these feelings because of how much time they invest and how much money they invest. Like, just think about anything that's like your favorite thing ever, right? Like, you spent so much of your life dedicated to this thing. You spent so much of your money dedicated to this thing. So you want to feel like you're a part of something. And sometimes people do that with being fake mad. That's what I think. You know, man.
When you mad about a game having a 2 instead of a 3 on the end,
that's beyond something.
It just makes no... I understand why they're saying that, but really? Like, nobody really even played Red Dead Revolver.
And not only that, but people are acting like there's never been sequels to sequels before. Like,
yeah, like Red Dead Revolver and Red Dead Redemption aren't even the same game.
That's what I'm saying. It's like, first of all, like, it's not unheard of, first of all. Like, Final Fantasy's done it, like X2 and all that stuff. Like, Final Fantasy's done it. Right. How many games have a number at the end of it, but that's not the number of the actual, like, installment? Like, GTA 5 isn't the fifth GTA. Like, who cares? Like,
God of War 2.
Who cares?
God of War don't even got a number behind it. It's just God of War.
Exactly. Who cares? And Battlefield 1 is not the first Battlefield, but who cares?
Xbox One. Who, you know, they're silly cares? Names sometimes, but it's still, you know, a completely different product. Exactly. And we should be excited for that product, you know what I mean? Exactly. So I was getting a kick out of everybody.
Yeah, for no reason.
I was getting a kick out of it, but at the same time, it was making me, like, legit mad. Because I'm like, y'all should just be mad that the game was even announced. Like, y'all shut up. Y'all stupid. Shut up.
Yeah. Imagine when the trailer comes out. It might even be worse. So.
Oh, my God.
You know, Rockstar ain't showing much. They'll be mad.
Yeah, it'll be a super teaser, probably.
All I'm going to say is,
I don't know.
People just need to shut up and be happy.
We're not, because, like, I'm sorry, Nia. Like, gamers say they know what they want, but when you give it to them, they don't want that no more. They don't know what they really want. Sometimes I don't even know what I want sometimes.
Yeah, I admit that too.
Then when I get it, I don't want it.
Like, dang, you know what? Maybe this is a good game. Maybe this is great, actually.
I mean, it is what it is. Gamers don't know what they want.
That's true.
I think developers are scared to give people something different because they scared people ain't gonna like it, because people won't say they want something and then they don't want it.
Mm-hmm. And then if it's too similar, then they complain
that's too reasonable.
There's like a fine line, and for developers to hit that, I mean, you're asking a lot.
That's true.
Rockstar is just like, you know what, y'all gonna take what we give you and you gonna like it.
You're gonna love it.
And you know what? And the crazy thing about it is that most people will love it. Most people will buy it. And when it comes out, people are not going to be able to deny that it's going to be great.
So yeah, they're just fake complaining right now. Like, I'm like, yo, like, you really worried about the number at the end of the game? Like, come on. It's not that deep.
What do you guys think about a PC version? You think that'll happen?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I knew one. If anybody who had a PC thought that the port was coming day one with the consoles,
maybe another year or so.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Because, like, people have to remember that even though, like, consoles are becoming more similar to PC now, like, consoles are still, like, set boxes. They don't really have to worry too much about, like, like, me and Erica, like, we both have PCs, but our PCs have completely different specs and completely different parts. So I would rather them, you know, take the time to make sure that the PC version works on the most people's PCs. Then, you know, like, some situations where people bring out games and, like, they don't even care, you know? So it's like, take your time and it'll come when it comes, you know? Yeah, it just is what it is.
Like, how long for them to get GTA on PC? But you
exactly,
got it.
But they got it. So it's like,
And then you got the superior version at that.
People will be okay. I've come to the conclusion that, you know what? I see you mad, but you will be okay.
Yeah, like,
be all right.
Let me ask you a question, Erica. Were you even surprised? Like, were you surprised? Like, it's not coming?
To what, PC?
Yeah, to PC.
Were you surprised?
Were you like, it's coming like a year?
I figured, well, what makes it tricky is the first one never came to PC.
Exactly.
So I think people are flipping out thinking that'll happen again. But I think we just have to wait and see. Usually it'll come later. So I don't know.
And we just got breaking news. Nintendo NX is going to be shown tomorrow.
Don't believe it.
No. Where'd you see this at?
Nintendo of America retweeted it.
Nintendo of America didn't do that.
What? Oh, I see it. Yep. Nintendo at Nintendo America on Twitter.
Be among the first to discover NX. Watch the preview trailer at 7 a.m.
That's a lie.
Is that the same time as the Red Dead trailer?
Yes, it is.
Wow. What?
No, they didn't. Oh my God, they did.
Tim Gettys. Yeah, Tim. I'll retweet it. Tim Gettys just.
No, they didn't.
You know, Nia. I'll say it like this: Dr. Trey put it up.
No, I'm looking at the Nintendo of America Twitter. Like, this is real.
Okay, hold up. It says Red Dead trailer is 1 hour after. So NX first, then Red Dead.
Dang.
Just to be clear, just to clarify.
Yeah.
Well, Nintendo tomorrow just got even more interesting.
And I'll be at work tomorrow. Holy crap. Aww. So I'm going to miss both of them.
No, you're not. You're going to finally miss it.
Nah, I teach, bro. Like, I can't have my phone, bro. Like, that's automatic KO. I mean,
take the bathroom break.
You might feel sick tomorrow, Nia. I'm just saying.
You know
feel
what?
A little sick.
You know, I am feeling a little. You know, you're right about that. Dang
oh,
it.
Crazy.
I can't believe that happened right, as we were recording.
Right here on the first episode.
Yeah. On the first episode. This episode,
we got to get this episode up quick.
This might be up tonight, bruh.
Might have to.
Breaking news, y'all. I just saw that 3 minutes ago. Somebody already posted about it on YouTube.
And here I am calling you a liar. I will never, ever,
I will never doubt you again,
Janessa. I love you. You my sister. Mwah. I promise. We good.
Just looking right at it.
Because, you know, like, everybody's like, oh, the NX is going to be, like, no, it's
somebody
not.
Sent me a tweet. My one of my subscribers sent me a tweet in my mail, in my box.
Nice.
I believe
it says, "Nintendo of America."
I'm looking at it right now, bruh.
That picture, I'm just looking at that picture of Mario right now.
Yeah,
his feet
with the curtain.
Hey, right. His feet aren't showing, so does that mean we play with our feet? Confirmed. that's the new thing.
So dang. So NX, I don't think will it be shown or what are they gonna say?
I don't know. It says it's gonna be a preview trailer, so I'm not really expecting too much.
I hope they show enough to where we understand, okay, how is this system going to work? You know what I mean? Like, are we playing on a tablet? Are we playing on a 3DS type of thing? Like, right. What are we playing on? Oh, I just saw another tweet. NX preview trailer will be 3 minutes long.
Exactly.
That's pretty long.
No, it's not.
Yeah. I mean, well, maybe not for Nintendo, right?
I don't know, because this guy's pretty accurate.
No, it's like the actual Nintendo Twitter, so it's legit. All right,
multitask.
Well, let's finish up this episode so I can put it up on the site. Anyway,
for sure.
So thanks, you guys, for listening to this, and hopefully I can chop this up real nicely by the end of the night, because I do have to wake up early in the morning. Thank you, Erica and Janessa, so much for participating in my shenanigans, because this
of course, I was trolling this
web show is definitely something that just popped up in my head at the middle of the night. Like, I texted Janessa and Erica at the middle of the night, like, yo, I got an idea. And they were like, yo, what up? And they're like, you know what, that actually sounds pretty cool. They didn't laugh at me, so shout outs to them.
Well, that you know of, but
oh my god.
I'm just saying.
They laughing at me behind my back. They got a private chat like, yo, what's wrong with this guy?
Girl's tripping.
It's all good. But anyway,
it was fun.
It was fun. And hopefully the next episode we do this, we have a little bit more of a better setup, because we're still trying to get everything started. So, thanks you for watching again, and we'll talk to you later. Say bye, everybody.
See ya. Bye, everybody. Everyone.
So dead. I'm dead.
I couldn't even say everything.